Watch this video till the end to know the most important must-know topics of dermatology for NACT examination in the form of comparison and also case scenarios. Hello dear students, myself Dr. Madhanesh Shrinivas. Welcome to Crack Derma Dear MST. So let us begin our discussion with the first topic, which is the barefoot walking, or the examiner might also give you a patient is having a history of thorn prick. Okay, then what are all the DDs you need to think of and what are the case scenarios? If there is development of linear lesions along the lymphatics and the causative organism is a dimorphic fungus, the diagnosis is going to be sporotrichosis. But if the examiner mentions that there is development of swelling, granules are coming out through sinuses, that is there is a triad of GST, then the diagnosis you need to think of is mycetoma or Madura foot. And if the examiner gives you a clue that the lesion which is developing is a verrucous lesion with a rough surface and there are copper penny bodies, sclerotic bodies, muriform bodies, medullar bodies, then the diagnosis is going to be chromoblastomycosis, which is due to the dimeticious fungi. So depending upon what clinical features are given, thorn prick is going to manifest in these three forms. Next is the wood slamp examination findings. You need to remember the various colors. So remember corneal bacterial minutissimum, it is associated with erythrasma, and the fluorescence is going to be coral red fluorescence. Petrus is versicolor due to malassezia, globosa and furfur. The yellow fluorescence is very characteristic. Tinea capitis producing fungi, they are going to be associated mainly with the blue fluorescence. So these are some of the colors which you need to remember. Next is the shape of the lesion. So you can see this is the first lesion which is appearing like a ring, but it is having different center and a different periphery. So this comes under annular category. And what are all the diseases in which we can see the annular lesions? Yes, if you have thought of tinea, very good, absolutely correct. And if you have thought of the herald patch or mother patch, which is seen in Pityriasis rosea, wonderful, absolutely, you are correct. And if you have remembered the diagnosis of cutaneous leishmaniasis, then also wonderful, you are absolutely correct. Leishmaniasis, cutaneous leishmaniasis, and also lupus vulgaris, which is the most common type of cutaneous tuberculosis, that is also correct. It is also going to show the annular lesion. So these are all the diseases in which we are going to see the annular lesions. Very, very important for you to remember. And this is a lesion which is having periphery and active, which are active. Periphery and the center, both of them are active, and the lesion is looking like a coin like lesion. So this is what is called as discoid lesion, and discoid lesions are seen in discoid lupus erythematosus and discoid eczema, or it is also called as nummular eczema. Nummular eczema. One negative point which I want to tell is that in urticaria we are not going to see the annular lesions. Not urticaria. So this is what you need to remember. Not urticaria. Urticaria is not going to show an annular lesion. This is the recent question. Next question. So leprosy treatment is producing hyperpigmentation of the skin. What is the medication? So remember students, it is clofazimine. Remember rifampicin, it is associated with the secretions which will become colorful. So colored secretion is going to be seen with rifampicin. Very important. So next few one-liners, drug resistance most seen with which sexually transmitted infection? So remember students, it is gonorrhea, it is gonorrhea. Genitals having painful coalescing vesicles, fluid relations, painful inguinal lymphadenopathy. What is the diagnosis you need to think of? If you have thought of herpes genitalis, absolutely you are correct. Skin manifestation resulting from drugs used to treat the amoebic dysentery. So the medication is metronidazole, and the diagnosis you need to think of is FDE, which is fixed drug eruption. Systemic steroid withdrawal in the psoriasis patient is going to produce, remember, two life-threatening conditions, which is one is pustular psoriasis, where there are going to be sheets of pus almost involving entire body, and the next one is erythrodermic psoriasis. Erythrodermic is going to be associated with more than 90% of body surface area becoming red in color, associated with scaling. So these are the two important adverse effects we can say due to the withdrawal of the systemic steroids in the patients of psoriasis. Next, in this you can see that there are two conditions which are going to follow the segment, or we can say dermatome. In the first one, you can see that there is a vitiligo, which is initially progressive and later becomes stable and non-progressive. So this is very important. It is segmental vitiligo, in which in the picture you can see that on one side this vitiligo, that is depigmented patches, are present scattered, and it is not crossing the midline because segmental, that is dermatomal. just like another condition. What is another condition which you are able to see in this picture, which is manifesting with painful erythematous lesions which are fluid filled, which are following a single dermatome, and it is herpes zoster, which is associated with a lot of pain, and this is due to the reactivation of the varicella zoster virus, which lies dormant in the dorsal root ganglion. Very important. So there is a simple trick here. Yes, for segmental vitiligo, and remember students, this is going to become stable, because once the entire dermatome which is involved, there will not be any more progression once the entire dermatome is involved. And yes for segmental, yes for stable vitiligo, and also yes for subscribe to the channel. And also the treatment for segmental vitiligo is important. Again, yes, it is surgical treatment which is going to be utilized. This is also a question asked in the FMG exam. Next, in this picture, you are able to see that there is picture number 1, picture number 2, both of them are related. In the picture number 1, you are able to see there is an annular herald patch which is having very peculiar collaret scale. And in this next picture, you are able to see daughter lesions which are developing along the Langer's lines in the ribs in the Christmas tree pattern. So this is what is called as Christmas tree pattern. And what is the disease which you should remember with this both features? It is P. rosea or pityriasis rosea. Okay. Next, in the below, you are able to see one picture where a lady is having the frontal area hair loss, that is frontal alopecia. And this is a fibrosing alopecia, that is a scarring alopecia. So the diagnosis which you need to think of is frontal fibrosing alopecia, which is very important. It was asked almost twice. So there is one more associated feature in this frontal fibrosing alopecia. It is loss of the eyebrows. That is, it is also called as madarosis. In this picture, you can see that an elderly individual is having some pearly white nodular lesion present near the inner canthus. And here you are able to see an elderly person having ulcerative lesion. Whenever you see nodular ulcerative lesion in an elderly individual, that too above the line joining the angle of the mouth and the tragus, always you should think of the diagnosis of basal cell carcinoma. Very important, also called as rodent ulcer. It will not show any kind of metastasis, and it is going to locally spread, and that is the reason why there is ulceration. Next, this slide, very important slide, where you are able to see the vesicobulous disorders. So first picture which you are able to see, this is the clinical picture, and this is the DIF image. So clinical picture, you are able to see there are presence of the flaccid bullous lesions, where the lesions are showing a tendency to extend onto the surrounding normal looking skin. And if you do a biopsy, we can see row of tombstone appearance. And if you do a DIF, we are going to see the fishnet pattern. So with all these clues, what is the diagnosis for this first picture? It is very good if you have thought of pemphigus vulgaris, which is a intraepidermal blistering disorder. Okay, the next condition which you are able to see, this is a patient who is having the tense bullous lesions. It is a subepidermal blistering disorder, where you are able to see the tense bullae present over erythematous articarial skin. And if you do a biopsy, we can see subepidermal blister. And if you do a direct immunofluorescence, what are you able to see? A linear deposition of the IgG along the basement membrane zone. So now with these clues, what is going to the diagnosis? If you have thought of the diagnosis as bullous pemphigoid, you are absolutely correct. And below, you are able to see one more characteristic lesion which is described as crown of jewels, cluster of jewels appearance. And this is also a subepidermal blistering disorder, where vesicles are present surrounding this annular lesion. And if you do a direct immunofluorescence, we are going to see the linear deposition, but here the deposition is going to be of IgA. So this is what is called as linear IgA disease, or LIG, or it is also described as called as chronic bullous dermatosis of the childhood, CBDC. Very important. Next is the last picture which you are able to see. There is a patient who is having the excoriated papules which are present over the extensor surfaces, and there are no intact vesicles or bullous lesions, and this disease is associated with the gluten sensitive enteropathy, BROW, barley, rye, oats and wheat. And if you do a biopsy, subepidermal blister will be there. And on direct immunofluorescence, we are going to see the IgA. And what is the pattern? It is described as granular pattern. If you do a biopsy, we are going to see the neutrophilic microabscess in the dermal papilla. So what is the diagnosis here? It is dermatitis herpetiformis, which is also called as Brock's disease. Okay, so this is the next slide which you are able to see, the classification of the leprosy. Now the NLEP is also going to follow the World Health Organization. So a patient, even if it has one nerve involvement, they are categorized as multibacillary, and the treatment is going to be the same three medications, rifampicin, dapsone, clofazim, in the same dosages, but the duration is going to be different. In the case of PV, it is 6 months. In the case of the MV, it is 12 months. And in this picture, you are able to see that the leprosy patient, the pre-existing lesion is becoming inflamed. So this is type 1 lepra reaction, which is basically a type 4 hypersensitivity reaction. And here you are able to see there are new erythematous tender nodules which are developing over the body. So this is type 2 lepra reaction. And remember students, the treatment for both these conditions is going to be continue the multi-drug therapy and add steroids. Because in both of them, there's going to be inflammation. We are going to add the steroids in both these conditions. That's going to be the treatment. Next, in this picture, you can see post-Kala Azar dermal leishmaniasis and also leprometous leprosy present with hypopigmented macules and infiltrated nodules. So, how to differentiate? In the history, the examiner is going to give you a past history of prolonged fever in the case of post-Kala Azar dermal leishmaniasis. And if you do a slit skin smear, we are going to see the amastigote. So, this is microbiology. Next, in this picture, you can see that this is the gland which is opening into the hair follicle to throw out the secretions along the hair follicle, just like the sebaceous gland. So, this is the apocrine gland. Where are apocrine glands present? Remember, dear students, it is axilla, areola, and groin. And in this next slide, which you are able to see, so you can see the table is showing the treatments which are used for the psoriasis. And PUVA is psoralen and UVA therapy, and the associated adverse drug reactions, you need to match them. So PUVA therapy, it is associated with long-term usage with skin cancer. Cyclosporine, it is a calcineurin inhibitor, so it is effective, but it is highly nephrotoxic. Methotrexate, it is an abortifacient, if you remember from Opsgyny. Acitretin, it is an oral retinoid, just like isotretinoin, and it is associated with mucositis, and it is a teratogenic medication. These are some of the images which you are able to see. So the tongue is showing the corrugated whitish block, which is not easily scrapable. It is due to the Epstein-Barr virus, and the diagnosis is oral hairy leukoplakia. On this side, you are able to see a whitish patch which is going to be easily scrapable. This is oral candida. Next, here you are able to see a oil drop like appearance of the nail bed, and this is the pathognomonic sign seen in the psoriasis called as oil drop sign. And here you are able to see a black scab which is surrounded by the erythema, both of them together called as SCHAR. Remember students, SCHAR can be seen in scrub typhus, SCHAR can be seen in brown recluse spider bite, and also cutaneous anthrax. Very important. One negative point you need to remember is SCHAR is not seen in Kessler Forest disease. Okay. Next are lines which you need to remember in the case of dermatology. The first one which you are able to see, these are called as Blaschko's lines. How to identify scalp spiral nature of the lines can be seen, and on the anterior aspect they are S-shaped, and on the posterior aspect they are V-shaped. In the extremities they are linear, and also they are not going to cross the midline. Blaschko's lines. Next, on this side which you are able to see, these are the Langer's lines, which are going to cross the midline from left to right. There is no any midline demarcation. And Langer's lines, they are also called as, the other name is also important, RSTL, relaxed skin tension line. Basically, these are the lines along with the collagen fibers are going to be oriented. And if you remember the Thanos, Lord Thanos, the face of Thanos is going to be looking something like this. Langer's lines face. So you can remember this picture is going to be given, and you need to identify these lines. So Lord Thanos, L for Langer's lines. So if you want this exam to be your last exam, in the comments write down end game. Okay, Lord Thanos. Right. So some scales which you need to remember, silvery white scales are going to be seen in the case of the psoriasis, very important. Yellow greasy scales, seborrheic dermatitis, whereas brawny powdery furfuraceous scales can be seen in petrosis versicolor. Next, collarette scale, you know, petrosis rosea, fish-like scales, ichthyosis vulgaris, mica scales are seen in petrosis lichenoides chronica. Remember these names. And in this picture, we are able to see these Gottron papules, pathognomonic for dermatomyositis. And in this picture, this is salt and pepper pigmentation, which is very classically seen in the case of scleroderma. Genital ulcer disease is very, very important. So in this table, you are going to understand how to mark the answer for the sexually transmitted disorders. If a patient is coming with multiple painful genital ulcers, check for the lymph nodes in the inguinal area. If the bubo is present in the inguinal lymph node area, then the diagnosis is going to be chancroid, which is produced by Haemophilus Dukri. If the patient is having multiple painful genital ulcers and also inguinal lymphadenopathy is present and painful, but bubo is absent, no bubo, then the diagnosis is going to be herpes genitalis. Next, on this side, patient is having painless genital ulcer and also there is no lymphadenopathy. Diagnosis is going to be donovanosis, which is produced by Klebsiella granulomatis or Kallimattobacter granulomatis. Patient having painless inguinal lymphadenopathy along with painless genital ulcer, diagnosis is going to be, I hope all of you know, the syphilis. So you all know painful inguinal lymphadenopathy, which is a bubo seen in a patient having painless genital ulcer. Diagnosis now is going to become lymphogranuloma venerum. So this is going to help you to easily mark the answer of all the sexually transmitted disorders. Just take a screenshot and you can easily mark the answers. Treatment of onychomycosis, fungal nail infection, we are going to use the topical nail lacquer or the nail polish, which are going to be applied over the nail plate. And what are all those? You can remember with this simple mnemonic: CEAT, cycloperoxolamin, efinaconazole, amarolfin, tavaberol and terbinafine. So this was also a recent question, very, very important. So I hope this video was helpful. If so, please do hit that like button. Also share this among your friends, for your best friends, so that they are going to score very well in this INSET exam. And also do subscribe to this channel. And